Don't even think about it.
Hey, what? You don't know how to use an ashtray? It's really simple. Step one, press butt into ashtray, that's all.
Riding the bus and other forms of public transportation help the environment by reducing our dependency on fossil fuels.
Confucius say, do know to others what you would not want them to do to you. That is just gross.
All right.
What idiot could be that stupid?
Well, good afternoon.
Good afternoon.
That'll be $3.27. Will that be paper or plastic?
Neither.
Just a moment. I'm coming. Wait a sec.
So many people in one car.
We're carpooling. It costs us pennies a week.
Pennies?
Yeah. How much does this cost you?
It's costing me $70 a week.
Hi, Mr. Bianco.
Hi, nice to meet you.
My name is Anthony. I'm here to interview you for the Schiller Going Green project.
Wonderful. Take a seat.
Thanks. We were wondering what you've been doing to save energy, protect the environment, or promote the green theme the Schiller Center of Excellence has embraced?
Well, I don't own an automobile, so that in itself is saving energy.
But isn't it true that you live in Manhattan, probably the only place in America where people do not need to own a car?
Yes, that's true. When you have taxis and subways, why own a car?
So what's the difference in an energy burn when a cab driver drives you someplace versus you driving your own car?
Probably not much, if you take a cab, but in Florida, there's another way.
Come join us for our next adventure of Schiller Goes Green, because remember, if you're not part of the solution, you are part of the problem.
India discovers an advanced civilization that recycles paper. Number one and number two plastic, aluminum cans, highly toxic batteries, and the most highly toxic of all modern conveniences, old cell phones. But the biggest surprise of all is when he discovers a temple of doom lurking deep inside the bowels of the university, where the sacrificial recycling of empty computer printer ink cartridges is taking place.
Well, look who's back. My infamous protege. For more bull-whipping lessons, I assume? Did you bring me any ink cartridges? You didn't? You have a lot of nerve coming here empty-handed. Why don't we see if you can whip this, then? Indiana Jones. He's not even the toughest professor on campus.